Hello, this is Pia from Metal and High Heels. Standing here with Sophia from Season of Ghosts. First of all, thank you so much for playing Stargazer.
Thank you so much for watching the show, actually.
It was great.
Really happy, you know. I was very surprised, you know, that so many people turned up, you know, so early in the morning, you know. I didn't expect that, you know, because I wouldn't do it, you know, for my favorite bands. You know, I wake up, you know, traditionally, you know, after 11, 12. So, you know, playing at 11:20, I was like, okay, maybe I'm going to play in front of five people. But, you know, when I see people all the way to the back, you know, full, I'm like, okay, I give up. Belgian people or whoever people came, I admire your courage. That's it.
Is I read on your Instagram that you're not a morning person.
No, definitely not a morning person. You know, I sleep around like 5 or 6 and I wake up around 11 or 12. Mm-hmm. But so this was the first thing for me, you know, like the first kind of experience. Anyway, it was fantastic nevertheless. I should do it more often.
And it was the first gig ever for Season of Ghosts.
Yes.
Did you enjoy it?
It was the very first gig ever, you know. That's why I was super shaky, super stressed, you know. But, you know, I had very good members, you know, with me. Mm-hmm. The Ghost Legion boys, you know, I introduced them lately. They're my session band. And they are all Italian people. And I don't know, I feel very much at ease with them. They are very dependable, very nice people. Mm-hmm. And that's it. You know, they helped the first concert, you know, to be... You know, to be a really good one.
Yeah, I hope.
It was cool. And you had so much energy on stage, even though you're not a morning person. Yes.
Really? Because I don't remember much, you know, because I was very surprised and I was very shocked and I was like, oh my God, what the hell is happening, you know? But okay, if you say so, I believe you.
I think you...
I don't remember much.
I think you woke up the whole festival with the morning's aerobic
and so. Yeah.
Your album comes out in December. Mm-hmm. What can we expect from this album?
You can expect an emotional roller coaster, I guess. It's actually, you know what? What can I say about the album? Actually, it's all my compositions and also co-production. Mm-hmm. I even put my hands into the mix and the master, you know, in every step of the process. And actually, it's a very honest album. I didn't try to sound like anybody. I didn't try to force, you know, anything. I just wanted everything to come out pouring out of me, you know, naturally. So that's what I did. You know, I switched off all the lights, you know, and I sat on my piano and my guitar, and I said, okay, whatever comes out, I put it on the album. Well, the production manager agreed, so that's how it came out to be.
Cool. And where will it be available?
It's going to be available just one day after my birthday, on the 8th of December, by Corona Records. And internationally, it's an international release date. Mm-hmm. And okay, there's talks about Japanese release, but we're not sure about that yet. But let's hope.
Please explain the title, The Human Paradox.
Okay, I saw that one coming, actually. Well, just like, you know, the title track suggests, there is a title track, you know, called The Human Paradox. And if you read the lyrics, you can actually get the whole concept of the album. In fact, you know, The Human Paradox is a concept album. It talks, you know, about the process of life, you know, through the eyes of a wanderer, which should be me, you know, through my eyes, actually, from a more spiritual point of view. And The Human Paradox is, you know, that's, you know, humans, you know, can be so beautiful and at the same time they can be so terrible. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, you know, we give all our love and attention, you know, to things that bring us so much disaster and pain, and, you know, we neglect, you know, the things that are freely given to us and that are positive to us. You know, it's just crazy, you know. Sometimes you just sit in the end of the day and you say, what the hell am I doing? Like, why do I neglect such a fantastic person, you know, in front of me? And why do I love such a terrible person, you know, that's pushing me around? That's it, you know?
Okay.
In a nutshell.
And you have this keyhole symbol.
Yes.
Is it something, because you can look through the keyhole and see something, some secrets or something? Or what is the idea behind this symbol?
Well, the idea behind this symbol is like the truth inside the truth. Mm-hmm. Like, whatever you see on the surface, you know, you can have a keyhole and you can look inside. You have to read between the lines, you know, in everything. Just the surface, you know, the surface can be good, you know, it can be comforting, you know, it can be, you know, enough for you. But if you look inside, you know, there's many, many things that you can find out. okay, sometimes they are pleasant, sometimes they are not very pleasant. But personally, you know, being me, you know, I like to look nevertheless. Mm-hmm. That's it. That's a keyhole, you know. I like to see differently.
Okay. You already said you did the co-production of the album, so you're a workaholic.
Yes, I'm a notorious workaholic. Like you can tell from my eye bags and my black circles here. Although I try meticulously to cover them with
yes
concealer. You know, I don't know how effective it was.
It was.
Okay, well,
you look great.
Okay, well, yes, I'm a notorious workaholic. I spend most of my day in front of my computer, mm-hmm. and that's why I like an exercise. You know, so lately I try to go back to the gym. But other than that, you know, I just like to dedicate myself to my work. And right now, exactly because it's my solo project, it's what I do. It's my child. Mm-hmm. I try to do the best I can. So this means more hours in front of the computer than usual. But I don't mind at all, you know, because everything, you know, the result is so rewarding. And if people, you know, if people come to me and say, you know, that look, I like the album or I like the show, you know, that like so many people came out said it to me today, that's my payment, that's my reward, you know, that's the ultimate thing, you know. I say, okay, it was worth it, I don't give a damn, you know, it's fantastic.
Yeah. Are there any plans for 2015?
Yes, many plans, more plans than I can handle, actually. I don't know, like possible tours, you know, in Europe, in America, in Japan, mm-hmm. and, you know, more releases, probably free releases, you know, because I like to do, you know, free covers, mm-hmm. you know, with my partner Zombie Sam. You can expect lots of things from us, lots of surprises, you know. I cannot reveal anything right now, mm-hmm. but there's lots of projects coming up, yes, and definitely tours, definitely. So I'm going to meet, you know, many of you pretty soon around the world, so expect me.
You have a big fan base in Japan, and is there a special plan for the Japanese people?
For the Japanese people, yes, I always have, you know, I have a soft place, you know, in my heart, you know, for the Japanese people, because that's exactly where I started from. Mm-hmm. And they've always been, you know, so supportive, you know, and so heartwarming, you know, all around Japan, you know, in every state. And, you know, I just want to go back and see, you know, each one of them, you know, every single fan. I'm very emotional, you know, with my Japanese fan base, mm-hmm. you know, because, you know, when I started, you know, I was very inexperienced. I was very scared. You know, and I used to get, you know, panic attacks, you know, with social phobia and stuff like that. I was very, very scared. And they've been all so supportive and so nice. So I owe it to them. I owe it to them.
We can still see the Japanese touch in your outfit because it's very detailed and everything. Is it a special design for you, or where did you get
this
the clothes?
This specific costume is not a special design for me, no. But I have one lined up for me, you know, for the start of 2015. Mm-hmm. This one is by the brand called Presence. This one piece, the PVC one. I don't know if you can see it. It's too much PVC for 11:20 in the morning, and too much feather. But who cares? Rock and roll. Anyway, no. This is not a special model for me, but I have a secret collaboration coming up for the next year.
Okay, I'm looking forward to it.
Yes.
What do you think about crowdfunding?
Crowdfunding. It's not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing, but you know, I'm just a bit, you know, I'm old-fashioned, mm-hmm. and old-school, you know. And I was actually thinking about doing it, but I actually didn't do it. You know, eventually, I don't want to say bad things about it, but I don't know. I don't know what to say about crowdfunding. Actually,
okay,
it's not a bad thing. Like if you like it, you like it. If you don't like it, you don't like it. Actually, my record label didn't agree with it.
Okay.
So it's, you know, it's lifted, you know, the weight off my shoulders, you know, because, you know, I was wondering, do it or not do it, do it or not do it. So I didn't do it.
Okay. Let's talk a little bit about nutrition. Are you
nutrition?
Yes.
Okay.
You take care of your health and stuff. I saw it on Instagram.
Yes.
But you are not a vegan, are you?
No, I'm not vegan. I'm not vegan, actually. There's many reasons behind that. I love, you know, vegan nutrition and all mm-hmm. the fantastic, you know, recipes, you know, I see, you know, Instagram and other websites. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's financially very unsustainable if you live in Greece, I think, because everything it has to be imported. There's, you know, just the veggies and stuff, they can be Greek, but everything else, you know, has to be imported. Mm-hmm. We're very, very back in that aspect, you know, in Greece. We have some vegetarian products.
Yeah.
but it's unsustainable. Plus, you cannot lead a normal life. Like, for example, when you tour, you cannot ask, you know, the organizer, give me the vegan or whatever, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, I would feel rude, you know, if I asked that, you know. I don't know. I would feel very rude, you know. So I, you know, so I say, okay, give me whatever you got. Whatever is available is fine, you know. But, yeah, nutrition, I'm not a person who eats junk food too much. Of course, it's welcome whenever it's around. But, you know, usually I eat raw food a lot.
Yeah.
I don't cook much. But I love cooking, if I have to cook, and but I prefer, you know, to eat raw and to eat organic, and I mostly prefer vegetables. I don't like meat, no.
Okay. You do a lot of sport, but how do you keep fit on tours or when you're around here?
Actually, you know, to be honest, you know, for a decade or so, you know, I had abandoned sports. You know, I used to be a taekwondo athlete, and because I love sports, I love moving, and most of all, I love martial arts. And, you know, violent things. But anyway, I abandoned sports, you know, for a decade or so. And, you know, sitting in front of my computer, you know, I gained lots of weight. I gained lots of weight, not because of overeating, but because of over-sitting.
Yeah.
So it took a big toll on my health and my psyche. So this last year, you know, after finishing, you know, the Human Paradox, I said, okay, let's go back to the gym. So it set me free. You know, I remember, you know, how fantastic, you know, liberating it is to exercise, you know, to sweat, you know, all the stress of the day. It's liberating, you know.
Yeah.
But on tour, you know, I have a jump rope.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
And, you know, I have, you know, elastic bands. You know, all that funny stuff, you know, in my suitcase. You know, if somebody opens it, they're going to be like, WTF. Is she carrying, like, an unhealthy amount of feathers, you know, and jump rope? Okay, like, nobody will understand unless it's you or something, or somebody, you know, in the scene.
So the people under your room, they hate you because you're jumping all the time.
Yeah, well, I try to jump, you know, in humane hours.
Okay.
Not to be rude to anyone, you know.
You are into cat adoption.
Cat adoption, yes.
Please tell me about that.
Yeah, well, in Greece, you know, the stray animal problem is very, very big.
Mm-hmm.
And we have tons of stray cats mostly, okay, also stray dogs, but mostly stray cats, you know, and it really breaks my heart, you know, to see all those stray cats, you know, wandering around the streets.
Mm-hmm.
So especially, you know, at least in my neighborhood, you know, I'm trying to be as active as possible. You know, I take care of all the babies, you know, I neuter them, you know, I vaccinate them. Mm-hmm. I put them up for adoption, you know, in local organization.
Yes.
And, you know, I adopt some of them whenever I can, whenever it's possible, you know. But what did I do wrong here? Nothing. Okay, everything is in order. Well, one day I just, honestly, it's a dream of my life, you know. One day I wish I have enough money to personally, you know, fund the vaccination and the neutering of all the cats of my state or mm-hmm. something like that. Or make a house for cats and dogs and other stray animals.
Mm.
It would be, you know, it would mean a lot to me. I don't know. Mm. In this way, you know, I would support crowdfunding. I would do crowdfunding for this one,
mm-hmm.
but just for this one.
Okay. These were all my questions. Do you have something else to say to your fans?
What can I say? What I always say, probably, I don't know, like how many times you've heard it from me already, but study as much as you can. It's the single most powerful weapon, you know, to get by in life. That's what will get you forward, and be honest to yourself and be real. That's it. Honesty and truth.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.